Hey, for the hey. 536 here on 92.5 Fox News. Trey Radel, your host of The Drive. We always have a lot of fun on our show, even when we talk about some very serious things here. Chris Crowley's in studio with us. Chris Crowley, running for state attorney, 20th Judicial Circuit. This race has been nasty. Many people have called. I have shared some of the things. I mean, basically, from Herb just short of strapping up for ISIS to you being a felon. I mean, the stuff that's gone around has been nothing short of ridiculous. But hey, look, it's politics. It's the political season. On a very serious note, though, anybody listening to this, unless you're streaming us from somewhere outside of this area, you're going to vote on this race. And it's an important one. And we've got the primary that is just around the corner here. We did ask Amira Fox to come on with you to debate.
Great.
In the studio live.
She coming?
She will not. We are going to have her on
anytime,
at a separate time.
Anytime, any show. Sorry.
So, Chris, look, we will undoubtedly get to some of the allegations that have been thrown out. Even you having to turn yourself in for a raffle. I will share my idea of my opinion on how ridiculous some of the election rules are. But first of all, let's just take a step back. We'll take a deep breath here through everything you've been through. You and Amira are now in the home stretch here. Let's talk about you. Okay. Let me just start. We'll get to some of your background, but just the first question that I would ask you is, aside from your opponent, without talking about anybody else, why are you the best candidate to be Southwest Florida State Attorney?
Because I have the right mindset and right experience to get tough on crime. Chris Crowley, thanks for having me on your show. I have 15 years as a prosecutor, 20 years U.S. Army Reserve, Gulf War veteran. Right now, we have a complacent attitude towards crime, and we have some really challenging neighborhoods, Dunbar, Lehigh, Golden Gate, and we really need a new approach and some change at the state attorney's office. We desperately need change at the state attorney's office, which is the local prosecutor's office for the five-county area.
When you say new approach, what are some of the things that you think are different that you could do, that you could direct?
Sure. We have kind of a corrupt good old boy system in Fort Myers. You know, the right defense attorney, you get off with a slap of the wrist. I want none of that. Okay. I'm not supported by the criminal defense bar. I'm supported by the people. We collected 8,000 signatures to get on the ballot. I take a much more proactive approach on crime, working with the cops a lot better. Right now, the state attorney's office won't participate in task force they set up to fight crime in Dunbar. The state attorney's office resigned from the Police Chiefs Association. Both Amira Fox and Steve Russell resigned from the Police Chiefs Association because they had a spat with the Punta Gorda police chief. That's ridiculous. We need to work with the cops. Also, we really don't train the prosecutors very well. We just throw them into court. I'd like good practical training because they don't teach you how to try a case in law school. They teach you how to pass the bar. And a lot of the prosecutors go into court unprepared, scared, and they're eaten alive by a lot of the criminal defense bar. And I don't blame the criminal defense bar. I blame the prosecutor's office. So I take a lot more proactive approach, a lot more get tough approach, a lot tougher approach than my opponent. I really want to take a much more proactive approach as well. Work with the cops. If they set up a task force to fight crime in Dunbar, participate in it. Don't shun it. The state attorney's office has become very isolated, very complacent. It's a 39% conviction rate that we need to change. It's gotten very stagnant.
So a couple things to get to then, to get into the weeds with what sure. you're talking about. First of all, that they don't work with police officers. Let's get to one of these issues that has been brought up where there was some questions on whether or not you were the sort of the right man for the job.
Sure.
So two things just to kind of go over here.
Yeah.
You resigned from the statewide prosecution office. That's with the statewide.
When Charlie Crist was over there, I didn't get along with Charlie Crist. They had a very go-along attitude. They were giving out probation to heroin dealers, so a half kilo of heroin. Statewide prosecution is with the attorney general's office. I worked there 12 years ago. It wasn't a good fit. Charlie Crist, who a very, very liberal Republican, was giving sweetheart deals, substantial assistance agreements to everyone. After 8 months, it wasn't working out there. I quit. I would have been fired, but you move on. You know, I didn't get along with my boss. He was really more interested in trying to become a judge. I said, let's try some cases. Let's put some people in prison. Half kilo of heroin, and they're giving out probation. drug traffickers, cocaine traffickers. They're giving out real life sentences. And I said, well, what about the statutory minimums? Oh, we can get around those. We'll plead out to something less. My view is if you do the crime, you do the time, to quote Sammy Davis Jr. But I really take a much tougher approach. I'm not the good old boy system that you find so much in, especially in downtown Fort Myers, but you find it around any courthouse. I'm not the candidate of the criminal defense bar. I'm not the candidate of the liberal elite.
With regards to working with, by the way, you called Charlie Crist a Republican.
He was back then.
No, I'm only kidding.
I worked for liberal Charlie Crist for 8 months. I couldn't stand it. I ended up going back to the local prosecutor's office where I worked for 15 years.
That said, then, what happened? You got fired.
Well, people get fired. I would have been fired. I quit before I was fired.
From the state attorney's office?
No, I got fired from the state attorney's office because they didn't like me going on military leave. Okay? And we settled for a $30,000 out-of-court settlement. Okay? I worked there for 15 years, okay, at the state attorney's office, but they really didn't like the fact that I went on military leave. I'm sorry, I'm a Gulf War veteran. They didn't like me going on leave with the military. It's been a problem at the state attorney's office for years. But you move on, okay? I'm doing fine, okay?
And so with regards to law enforcement and working with them, I know that there were some letters, and again, like I've told you, I've received letters, sure, emails from people that support you, people that support Fox. There were letters that went around, but that they had no faith in your abilities.
There was one cop I had a little scuttle with 12 years ago.
But isn't that going
to... I'm just saying, I've worked with thousands of cops. I've prosecuted 100 cases, over 100 cases. My sister's a state policewoman in Massachusetts. I've worked with cops on tons of cases. Sometimes you get along with them and sometimes you don't. When I worked at statewide prosecution, the cops were upset that I was pushing a case to trial. They said, you always plead this out. It was one cop in Collier County who didn't like the fact that I was pushing him to translate all the undercover tapes, and that would have taken hours of work. And I said, come on, no, we got to do this. Sometimes, you know, I work with...
But you mean literally translate from like another language?
From Spanish.
Okay, understood.
Okay,
understood.
And one of the cops said, well, this isn't what statewide does. You guys always work out a plea agreement. And I go, well, no, this guy was caught with a half kilo of heroin. I want him to do the mandatory 10-year min-man. 10 yeah. years, that's, I'm sorry, 10-year mandatory minimum. And this cop said, your office never does that. And I go, maybe it's time for a change. And I was ruffling feathers with Charlie Crist. And I didn't see eye to eye with him or his staff. So I ended up leaving there. And yeah, I would have been fired anyway. And I ended up going back to the state attorney's office to prosecute there. That was 12 years ago, Trey. Okay, and I guess that's the best my opponent can come up with. That's great, okay? Besides having me arrested, but that's another story.
I do want to get to that in a second. Sure. Again, Chris Crowley in studio with us right now. Crowley2018.com is the website that you can go to. And anytime that I've ever had a candidate on here, I always share their website.
Thank you.
You can find them on social media as well.
Facebook.
Facebook, in fact. So let's get to some of those things, of the crazier aspects, I think, that have happened in this this race. We'll get to some of what I would call opposition research or whatever on Amira and this the her father's book and the arrest. There's one other thing that I did want to ask you about, though. The 39% conviction rate.
Yep.
I've had multiple emails and people who call and say that that's a bunch of BS.
It's on my website.
That have no idea how you calculated the rate.
We took total arrests from the fiscal year of 2016, which is October to October, and the total adjudications of guilty. We got this from the Florida Office of State Courts Administrator. 46,000 arrests, 18,000 adjudication of guilt. That's a 39% conviction rate. All this is on Crowley 2018. We went to the Lee County Clerk, looked at the Callan year for 2016, 38.5% conviction rate. We went to the Charlotte County clerk, 38.8% conviction rate. When you look at all the arrests, because just because you're arrested doesn't mean you're adjudicated guilty.
Sure.
And what happened was is that we found that the state attorney's office is dropping cases left and right. And I've had dozens of cops complain about this, that just because you're arrested doesn't mean the state files. And the state often wants a slam dunk case. And that's a problem. And they dump it and they dump cases left and right. And they don't even talk to the cops and tell them why. I've had hundreds of cops complain to me about this over the years. And the state attorney's office, often shy away from big cases. And then sometimes the big cases they take on, they end up losing, like the Lake Boys case. I think we can do a lot better. And I think all your listeners should expect better from the state attorney's office. they're not doing a good job, and we need change at the state attorney's office. And that's why I'm running for state attorney.
So the contention about that 39% is that, if first of all, that they say that the Office of State Court Administrator shows an 88.1 felony guilty disposition rate.
For the cases that make it to court.
Okay.
Yes. The cases that make it to court, that's the pick and choose cases, the cases they actually pursue, not the massive amount of cases they dump. For 2016, it was 86.8, but that's pathetic compared to the other circuits. Florida's divided up into 20 circuits. We're 15 out of 20. Most state attorney's office, prosecutor's office, have a 90% or better. Matter of fact, the 13th circuit has a 97.5. But those are the pick and choose cases. Those are the cases that actually make it to a courtroom. The state attorney's office here locally is 15 out of 20 for the cases that actually make it to a courtroom. They end up not filing and dumping so many cases that the effective, the real conviction rate is in fact 39%.
In studio with us, Chris Crowley, running for state attorney. If you are listening to this anywhere in our listening area, you will vote on this race in the primary, which is just around the corner here. Crowley2018.com is the website that you can go to. So the arrest.
Sure.
I when that story popped up, made abundantly clear that my own personal opinion on these ridiculous electioneering rules are so stupid. And the way that look, I don't want to go off on a tangent here, but I look at, as we're speaking about law, those election laws in the way that I do a lot of our country. I think that we are an over-incarcerated country. We can talk about that. That's another another time. But the fact that you got to turn yourself in because you had a friggin' raffle.
$670 raffle where all the money was returned and given to charity.
Yes, and again, we explain. So just to recap that.
It is
against the law in the state of Florida, not federally, to have a raffle when you are raising money for your campaign.
It's illegal actually to have any raffle if it's not going to charity.
Right.
So all your 50-50 raffles,
even more ridiculous,
all your 50-50 raffles at your Rotary clubs, at your Kiwanis clubs are illegal. Now it's rarely enforced, but Steve Russell and Amira Fox filed a complaint with the Florida Department of Law Enforcement.
Did they file a complaint,
yes,
though?
Yes, Steve Russell sent a letter. Steve Russell, who is campaigning for Amira Fox, sent a complaint to the Florida Department of Law Enforcement, who I ran over to and explained everything.
Didn't a whole new judicial circuit
eventually, yes. And then the case was dismissed because right when I entered the jail, I immediately entered into a diversion program. I pay a fine, and in about 3 or 4 months, the case goes away because it was so stupid.
I hear that.
My opponent had me arrested. This is politics at its worst. This is dirty. This is corrupt. And this is what the state attorney's office is about.
Amira Fox doesn't decide
she,
that. They work together.
They work together on everything,
right,
Trey.
Okay.
If you don't think Amira Fox had me arrested, I got a bridge to sell you. Okay? I'm sorry. My opponent had me arrested.
Either, but
it's
Russell
dirty.
Ended
it's
up
corrupt.
It to FDLE.
Eventually,
and it had nothing.
Well, he gave it to FDLE, and then finally it was relocated.
But what does he do? Not when the complaint is filed.
How about ignoring it? It's a stupid raffle where the money was returned.
But imagine ignoring it.
We have a cop killer on the street. We have gangs.
Now you're doing apples and oranges. What are they obsessed about?
A stupid raffle, Trey.
Listen, once again, the premise of the law, I agree with completely. I think that it's ridiculous. But I thought that Russell's hands were tied. I
mean, no, they weren't tied.
If he does not do anything, he's going to get crapped on. If he does something, he gets crapped on.
Nobody cared about this raffle. I'm here to talk about cop killers. Why was Desmarais charged?
$600, Crowley. I'm only kidding. You get
Desmarais, six prior felony charges, all dismissed by the state attorney's office. He should have been deported. He goes out, he kills a Fort Myers cop.
Yeah, part of that has to do with ICE.
The Lake Boys gang.
Laws.
The Lake Boys gang. All four not guilty. This is Amira Fox's crown jewel. Okay, she talks about it when we went out campaigning. She doesn't talk about it anymore. Won't talk about it here. But this was a drug gang. All four not guilty. They rushed it to trial for politics because we have a corrupt state attorney's office and a corrupt state attorney. We have serious issues about murder, about gangs, about a cop killer.
Listen, you're throwing those
animal cruelty.
Words,
what about animal cruelty in Buckingham?
Yeah,
We've got four illegal slaughterhouses.
What do we want?
We got to get Crowley on that raffle. That's nonsense.
Everyone needs to expect better. I'll take it back. It's not your fault, Trey, but I know.
And I'm glad to be on the show.
Obviously, you're fired up about this, and I think that some of the
subjects... Well, I'm fired up about crime.
I get it. But it's not like they're not doing anything about that while you also had...
They're failing.
The
39% conviction
the
rate.
The raffle. So, look, because we are a little bit pressed for time here, I'm going to start getting the stink eye here from Ian. One of the other things to wrap up about is something that you have been insistent about regarding Amira Fox and her father.
Well, the book that's dedicated to her, I've made an issue.
All right. Let me
Amira Fox has a PLO book that her father wrote dedicated to her that basically hates Jews. And I've challenged Amira Fox to denounce the book, and she won't. And I do think it's an issue.
I mean, this is a girl who grew up in Virginia, I'm sorry. I mean, what she stated is that this is something that her father wrote however long ago.
She won't denounce the book. You can buy it on Amazon.com, From Palestine to America. The book is an attack on the U.S., attack on Jews, and an attack on Israel. And it's dedicated to Amira Fox. Okay, and Amira Fox will not denounce the book. And I do think it's a point. I'm more concerned about that 39% conviction rate. I'm more concerned about cop killers on the street. I'm more concerned about the Lake Boys gang, and I'm more concerned about animal cruelty in Buckingham. But one issue, yes, is this book, and what are her values? And it has come up in this race, okay? You can't claim to be a conservative right-wing Republican and hate Jews and hate Israel, and that's what
but
that book does.
But she has never, ever... Look, this is something that her father wrote, and I get it that
dedicated it to her.
And
he gave her $1,000 for her campaign.
But you cannot say that she hate. Come on, the air and say she hates Jews.
She won't denounce a book dedicated to her that hates Jews.
Well, we'll see if she does whenever she gets on this show.
She won't. I challenged her to it in June. What was her response? She had me arrested.
Okay. Well, I think that you're stretching a little bit there. But
right.
Look. With her father's book, I mean, there are a lot
her
of people.
Her smiling
that look
photo
at this.
Is in it twice, Trey.
A lot
her
of
smiling adult photo is in the book.
Again,
you can buy a copy. I'll get you a copy on Amazon.
A lot of people look at it though as if, you know, what happens, and I've always talked about this on the air. If you're going to get involved in politics, people and Apple Research people are going to go and they're going to hunt down your father, your mother, your children. Your spouse.
My father was a security guard. Okay,
I know
he didn't write anti-Semitic books and dedicate it to me. Okay. I've never been involved with the KKK, nor is anyone in my family, okay? Amira Fox has a deeply anti-Semitic book dedicated to her, and she will not denounce it.
Well, we'll see when she gets on the air whether or not what she has to say about it.
Well, I'm ready to go for a debate in studio anytime, anywhere.
And for the record, we invited her on, and she would not come in at the same time as you to do any sort of debate.
Doesn't like to talk about these issues. Desmarette, she will not explain why Desmarette was loud on the street, why they dismissed his 6 prior felonies.
Chris Crowley in studio with us. Again, it's Crowley2018.com. I know that we've got to wrap up here, but I'll leave you with the last words.
If you really want to get tough on crime, if you want a new proactive approach, I'm asking you to support me in the Republican primary. My name is Chris Crowley. I'm a 15-year veteran of the state attorney's office. I'm a 20-year veteran of the Army Reserve. I'm a Gulf War veteran. And I really want change at the state attorney's office. A 39% conviction rate is just not good enough. What's going on with cop killers walking the streets and not being deported, what happened with the Lake Boys gang, these are just symptoms of a state attorney's office that has just fallen apart. I want change. I want to take on the good old boy system. No more sweetheart deals for the right attorney. I'm asking for everyone's vote and support in the primary, which is coming up on the 28th. My entire election is determined in the Republican primary. So I'm really speaking to registered Republicans out there. If you're a registered Republican in the 5-county area of Southwest Florida, I'm Chris Crowley. I'd love to have your vote. And of course, my website is Crowley2018.
Crowley2018.com is where you can visit him. Thank you for your time tonight. We appreciate
Thanks for having
it.
I'd love to come back anytime.
Thank you. 5:55 here on 92.5 Fox News. Trey Radel, your host of The Drive. Be right back.